In this lesson, we're going to calculate an unknown length and angle using the sine rule. The sine rule is here, and we use this rule to find an unknown length, and we use the rule below it, I'm circling in red, to calculate an unknown angle. When we deal with non-right angle triangles, we have capital letters that represent an angle. And opposite the angle, we have the length, which we represent using the same letter but the lowercase. So to begin with, we're going to work out the length of B using the blue formula. So we have B over the sine B, which is the angle, is equal to, and we have a matching pair of angle and length with the A. So we have A over sine of A. B we're trying to find, but we know the angle B is 52 degrees. So B over the sine of 52 is equal to A, which is the length of the opposite side, 3 centimeters over the angle 40 degrees. And now we need to move the sine of 52 to the other side of our equation. We do this by multiplying both sides by sine 52. So these will cancel. So we have B is equal to the sine of 52 multiplied by 3 over the sine 40. And we can work this out on our calculator. We work out the fraction first, and then we multiply it by the sine of 52, and we get 3.6822 decimal places. So the length of B is 3.68 centimeters, and that is to 3 significant figures. So now we can work out the length of C, but to do this, we need to work out the angle C. But we have angles in a triangle, where angle C would be 180, take away the other two angles. So angle C would be 88 degrees. And now we can use C over the sine of C is equal to A over the sine of A. This is just like we did to calculate the length B. We can put the values in. So C over the sine of 88 is equal to A, which is 3 over the sine of 40. Again, we multiply both sides by the sine of 88 to leave C the subject of the equation. So we have the sine of 88 multiplied by 3 over the sine of 40, and that works out as 4.66 centimeters to 3 significant figures. Okay, question B, we're going to use the red rule to calculate the size of angle B. Do you want to try this yourself by pausing the video, and you can resume it when you're ready. Okay, so we're going to work out the size of angle B. To use the sine rule, we need an opposite pair of angle and length, which we have with A and the opposite side, A. And because we want to work out an angle, we're going to use the red rule. So the sine of angle A, the sine of A over the opposite side, which is lowercase a, is equal to the sine of angle B over the length of the opposite side, which is B. We can substitute the values in. So the sine of angle A, which is 35 degrees, over the length of the opposite side, which is 9, is equal to the sine of B, B the angle we're trying to find, over 7.2. Now, we need to multiply both sides by 7.2 to make sine B the subject of the equation. So we have the sine of 35 over 9 multiplied by the 7.2 is equal to the sine of angle B. So we can work this out on a calculator and we get 0.4589 is equal to the sine of B. And now because we want to make B the subject, we need to apply the arc sine of both sides. So these will cancel. So we're left with B is equal to the arc sine of 0.4589. So angle B is equal to 27.3 degrees. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you found that useful. Thanks again and take care.